My dear students, I am Dr. P. Suganya, working in the Department of Food Processing and Preservation Technology, Avinashalingam University. So today we will see about the coating of food materials. Coating of food materials creates many problems in fruit coating using packs today. But coating is one of the best preservation method for fruits and vegetables. The materials used for coating is most important factor in these cases. Recently, coating enter into encapsulation technology also. Let us see about introduction and importance of coating materials in food preservation. Fruits and vegetables are respiring even after harvesting. To controlling the respiration rate is a challenging task to enhancing the shelf life of fruits and vegetables. Many technologies are adopted to preserve fruits and vegetables to maintain the freshness till consumption. Reduced respiration in fruits and vegetables improve storability, maintain freshness and prevent senescence. Coating is one of the important preservation technology for foods. In China, during 12th century, recorded coating preservation of citrus fruits. Later, lard and fat was used in England to enhance the shelf life of meat products. In mid 20th century, coating technology was used to prevent moisture loss and to make shine in fruits and vegetables. Sugar coating on confectionery also absorbed during this period. Coming to the objectives of this module, after going through this session, you will be able to acquire knowledge about the importance of coating in food preservation and to explain the coating materials used in food preservation. In modern techniques, the coating materials protect the foods as well as they releases active agents such as antioxidants, gas absorbers and browning agents, which has the capability of preserving food quality either by direct coating or incorporation into film matrix onto the coating material. For example, antimicrobial agents which are used to prevent bacterial and fungal growth on the food materials or directly coating on the food packaging films like low-density polyethylene and PVC, etc. Natural protective layer is present in the surface of some fruits and vegetables to protect them from natural environmental fluctuations such as temperature, humidity, microbial attack and light. This protective layer has a layer of waxy crystals on their surface which helps to reduce transpiration and hence water loss. The similar technology is used to preserve the food materials to maintain freshness and to increase the shelf life of foods, and such process is called edible coating technique. Coating in food preservation is applicable as a bulk material on the surface, for example, fruit and vegetable coating, and also methodology applicable to food ingredients like encapsulation. The natural edible active agents like antimicrobial extracts, antioxidants, anti-browning, edible wax and chemical preservatives, lipids, proteins, carbohydrates and resins are commonly used for coating purpose. The novel active agents such as chitosan, essential oil, nanomaterials are also used in food preservation. The combination of starch protein with lipid materials form composite films, which is having better barrier properties. The composite additives are used in encapsulation technology and emulsions are used for design and development of delivery component, functional foods, food colors, flavors, etc. Now, look into the biochemical changes occurs during ripening. Numerous biochemical and chemical changes takes place in fruits and vegetables. The plant cells use oxygen and release carbon dioxide during respiration, which makes the metabolic activities. In fruits, ethylene gas is evolved which accelerate ripening. In climacteric fruits, pigment development, conversion of acid to sugar, soft texture, development of aroma and flavor are takes place even after harvesting. The cell structure gets deteriorate during over-ripening and will become susceptible to pathogens. So the figure 1 explains the maturation, ripening and senescence of tomato fruit. Though many technologies are adopted to enhance the shelf life of foods, And to maintain freshness of fruits and vegetables, food coating technology also takes an immense role in food preservation. Coming to importance of food coating, the first one is consumer appeal. Coating of foods retain their color, freshness for many days. The consumer judges the product quality by its color and appearance. Hence, the maintenance of physical appearance is desirable in marketing point of view. Food coating improves color for certain foods. For example, waxing of cassava can increase the shelf life for many days also, which prevented discoloration. The second one is prevention of moisture loss. Though the natural cuticle layer is present in fruits and vegetables, which act as a barrier for moisture loss, vaporization occurs due to pores and micro cracks in the cuticles. The figure 3A shows the water vapor transformation in fruits and vegetables, and figure 3B exhibits the coating prevents the moisture loss in the surface of the food material. The coating arrests the pores in the cuticle, which reduces the moisture loss. Next one is less economic loss. Since the moisture loss is significantly controlled due to coating of fresh fruits and vegetables, the weight loss is prevented and hence the economic loss is reduced. Next one is reduced post-harvest decay. Coating materials act as a barrier for the growth and development of bacteria and fungus after harvesting. Hence, the different types of coating material prevent the growth of spoilage and pathogenic microorganisms. Sometimes, the coating materials are incorporated with fungicides to prevent spoilage. Next is increased shelf life. Almost all the fruits and vegetables respire after harvesting. The coating process creates a modified atmosphere on the fruit surface, and the availability of oxygen is decreased and ethylene production is reduced, and hence carbon dioxide concentration is increased. So, the respiration rate is gradually reduced and the shelf life of the product is increased. Ultimately, marketing value of the product is increased. Next one is reduction in chilling injury. When plant materials are exposed to low but non-freezing temperature, the physiological disorders occurs in plant material, which reduce their quality and loss of product. This change is called as chilling injury. Chilling injury occurs between 13 degrees Celsius and 0 degrees Celsius, depend on the crops. Coating of food, especially wax coating, reduces the chilling injury. Next one is retention of nutritional quality. The edible coating on food materials retains color, acid, sugars and flavor components. Next one, reduction in oil intake. The coating material is used to reduce the oil intake of food products during frying. Next important one is the biodegradability. Disposal of plastic materials are the greater environmental issue today. The biodegradable materials are one of the solution for this issue. Biopolymers, plasticizers and other additive materials are biodegradable and environmental friendly. The physical and mechanical protection. The bio-coating materials protects food from physical and mechanical damages. These bio-coating materials have lower tensile strength and sensitive to moisture. The physical strength of coating materials are reduced when exposed to high relative humidity, also at elevated temperatures. Next important one is a convenience. Coated fruits and vegetables have higher resistance against tissue damage and bruising caused by physical impact and vibration during transportation. The surface dehydration, ripening, absorption of moisture are retarded, and visual quality, surface smoothness and market related qualities are improved by bio-coating materials. The last one is a carrier for active agent and controlled release. In advancement in coating, these materials are act as carrier material for secondary plant metabolites, phytochemicals and other active and functional ingredients, pharmaceuticals, nutraceuticals in the form of capsules, soluble strips, coating in food substances, etc. Also, bio-coating materials have controlled release of active substances. Now, let us look into the components of edible coating. Polymeric materials are the most important ingredient of most of the food coating materials. Polymers such as starch, protein, and gums are used as coating materials. These materials are natural, edible, non-toxic and simple derivatives of cellulose. The coating made from polymeric edible films are flexible and tough enough. Polysaccharides. The natural plant materials such as cellulose derivatives, chitosan, pectin, starch derivatives, carrageenans, alginates, resins and gums are used as coating materials to increase the barrier properties. Proteins. The materials such as wheat gluten, soy corn zein, collagen, gelatin are the used as coating materials. Either a single component or combination of two or many components are used to make coating films. The next category is lipids. Lipid film coatings are categorized as surfactants and waxes. Lutein and lecithin are categorized as surfactants. Beeswax, carnauba wax and paraffin wax are categorized under waxes. Lipids are hydrophobic in nature and hence reduce moisture loss in food materials. Wax coating is practiced for a long time of preservation of fruits and vegetables. Carnauba wax, castor wax, beeswax, lecithin, petroleum based wax are commonly used for coating purpose. The next category is resins. Resins are translucent yellow or brown semi-solid material collected from plants which are used in lacquers, adhesives and synthetic plastics. Resins are act as least permeable barrier to gas and medium permeability towards moisture. Shellac, wood resin, copal are used in food coating purposes. The table shows the FDA approved coating materials that has some limitations of coating of fresh fruits and vegetables. That partially hydrogenated rosin, calcium salt of partially dimerized rosin and oxidized polyethylene. These are all some of the materials that is used in coating of different types of fruits and vegetables. Sometimes improper coating of lipids result in surface burn to the product. Also, if the temperature of coating material is high, this leads to tissue damage. If coated materials are subjected to excessive heat or moisture, wax may whiten on the surface of the product. When the coated product is removed from the cold storage and exposed to ambient temperature, this problem occurs. When pure shellac is coated with fruits and the product is transferred from cold temperature to higher temperature, sweating is introduced on the product surface. This makes partial solubility of shellac and resulted in white deposits which affect the appealing of the fruit. Next one is the composite films. The composite film or coating is formed by an addition of polysaccharides on protein layer over a lipid layer. This is a bilayer emulsion. This lipid material is dispersed or entrapped in protein or polysaccharide matrix. This composite film improves gas and moisture barrier properties. Especially, this film has excellent water vapor barrier than emulsion films. The composition and distribution of composite materials are highly responsible for barrier properties. Also, increased degree of saturation of chain of fatty acids in lipids, volume fraction and drying conditions significantly affect the barrier properties. Let us see about components of additives. The first one is emulsifier. The combination of two immiscible liquids where one liquid dispersed in the other between 0.1 and 100 micrometer is called as emulsifier. The emulsifiers keep the components in solution. Food grade structural components are constructed by using bioactive components of lipids, surfactants and biopolymers which are extracted from plant origin. For example, soy, starch, pectin, etc. This film matrix should be carefully selected to obtain better quality product. It should not affect the appearance, texture, stability and biochemical components of the product. Viscosity, stability, release characteristics and optical properties are the most important physicochemical characteristics of emulsion for coating. The next one is plasticizers. Plasticizers are required starch and protein based materials in most cases of coating which are added to the polymers to reduce the brittleness. The intermolecular force between polymer chain is decreased and hence the flexibility and extensibility is increased when plasticizers are incorporated. Plasticizers in protein-based coating. Good strength and flexibility is required for food materials to prevent cracking during handling and storage of foods when protein coating materials are incorporated. To increase the flexibility, low molecular weight plasticizers are included. Some of the commonly used plasticizers with protein and lipid materials in coating of foods are polyethylene glycol is used as coating component on fresh citrus fruits, resinous and polymeric coating. Propylene glycol and sorbitol are used in polymeric coating. Acetylated monoglycerides are used as emulsifiers and coating components. Lauric acid is used in coating of fresh fruits. The polyols, the glycerol and sorbitol are the most commonly used plasticizers for protein-based coating. The next one is the plasticizers in starch-based coating. Polysaccharides used in coating of food materials plays a numerous roles. Hardness, adhesiveness, thickness, compactness and mechanical properties are the major advantages of water-soluble polysaccharides. Plasticity of the coating materials are improved by the addition of polyglycol and glycerin. The next one is antimicrobial components. Food safety is concerned, food materials should be prevented from microorganisms in coating materials. Benzoic acid, sorbic acid, lactoferrin, propionic acid, bacteriocins, essential oil and phytochemicals are the most common antimicrobial agents incorporated in coating materials. The fresh strawberries are coated with starch-based potassium sorbate incorporated in coating materials to reduce the microbial growth and to extend the shelf life of the fruit. Salmonella was effectively inactivated by hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose coating containing ethanol on surface of tomatoes. Chitosan coating was incorporated with lysozyme for enhancing the antimicrobial activity against Escherichia coli. Now, look into the classification of some antimicrobial agents allowed for use in food coating. Benzoic acid, cloverbud oil, potassium sorbate, these are all some of the important antimicrobial agent and also act as a preservatives. The next one is antioxidant components. To retain the color in food materials and to prevent oxidation rancidity, oxidation components are incorporated in coating materials. Ascorbic acid, ascorbyl palmitate, butylated hydroxyanisole, butylated hydroxytoluene, citric acid, propyl gallate, tocopherol, these are all some of the active components used as antioxidant materials. Ascorbic acid is used to prevent enzymatic browning in fruits and vegetables. Xanthane gum coating with tocopherol improves the nutritional quality and surface color in carrot. Nuts are coated with pectinate and zinc containing BHA and BHT to prevent rancidity. Functional components. Biocoating materials are very good to enhance the nutritional value of fruits and vegetables. High concentration of calcium, vitamin E significantly increased when carrot is coated with xanthane. Calcium, zinc and vitamin E containing chitosan coating fortify fresh fruits and vegetables. Flavor and coloring agents also incorporated in edible coating to enhance the sensory qualities of foods. Polysaccharides, proteins and lipid materials that act as a coating material in most of the food materials. And also the maximum level of additives used in surface treatment as per Codex Alimentarius Commission.
Microcrystalline wax, riboflavin, glycerol esters of wood rosin, sulfites, phosphatates are some of the additives that is approved by Codex Alimentarius Commission.
The carrier and control release of active agent. The coating materials act as carrier material and also they have controlled release of active agents. Coating materials such as lipids, plasticizers are incorporated with active agents depends upon the application. For the controlled release of antimicrobials, multiple hurdle approach is mandatory to reduce the contamination. Starch-based carrier. The starch-based carrier materials have controlled release of flavors and aroma components. Source of starch, preparation condition, modification process and additives takes major role while controlled release of active agents. Sago starch with the addition of glycerol as a plasticizer facilitates dispersibility of lemongrass oil and enhance the rate of release is increased. Chitosan based carriers. Chitosan materials provide surface antimicrobial protection and also act as carrier for releasing active agents. Chitosan starch film, the electrostatic interaction between amine groups of chitosan and carboxyl groups of acid preservatives. At elevated temperatures during release of active agent, chitosan increases the solubility of active agents due to its increased kinetic energy. Protein-based carriers. When Arugula oil released from whey protein isolate resulted in better inhibition of bacteria. Protein made of different types of amino acids. Difference in amino acid content and density of changes of different proteins are chosen as a carrier material depends on the applications. Swelling rate and moisture absorption capacity of zinc film is higher when comparing to wheat protein. The bee wax retards the diffusion of sorbate in wheat protein. Now, we see about the cellulose-derived carriers. The cellulose-derived substances such as methyl cellulose, hydroxypropyl cellulose, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, carboxymethyl cellulose, cellulose acetate and ethyl cellulose are commonly used for coating purpose. Okay. Let's see about the summary. Many technologies adopted for preserving food materials immediately after harvesting, especially for fruits and vegetables. Materials such as polysaccharides, protein, lipids and resins are used for food coating. Convenience, consumer appeal, moisture and gas barrier, reduced post-harvest delay, increased shelf life, reduction in chilling injury, retention of nutritional quality, reduction in oil intake, carrier for active agents and controlled release are the important roles of coating materials. The emulsifiers, plasticizers, antimicrobial components, antioxidant components, anti-browning agents and functional components are incorporated with coating material to enhance the quality parameters and shelf life of the product. Carrier materials based on chitosan, protein, cellulose-derived materials, starch are used in encapsulation technology and these materials have controlled release of active agents. In the next lesson, we will discuss about different types of coating materials and methods of coating. Thank you.